What's the deal with Catholics and relics? If you go into a Catholic church, there's a good chance that there's somebody's bones or a drop of their blood in the altar. And you might even see, particularly in older European churches, the bones of the saints on display, with people praying in front of them. So what's the deal with that? Why do we venerate the bodies of the saints? Isn't that superstitious? Well, the first thing to realize is that Scripture gives a great importance to the body. There's sometimes this idea, particularly in the modern world, that I'm just a ghost living in a meat shell, and that death is me being freed from my body. But that's not the biblical or the Jewish or the Christian understanding of the body at all. Rather, the idea is that I am both a soul and a body. That's why, for instance, when the Israelites came out of Egypt, Moses took the bones of Joseph with him. We read in Exodus 13, verse 19, that Moses took the bones of Joseph with him, for Joseph had solemnly sworn the people of Israel, saying, "God will visit you, then you must carry my bones with you from here." That's also why the Catechism in paragraph 2300 says that burying the dead is a corporal work of mercy. The Catechism puts it like this: the bodies of the dead must be treated with respect and charity in faith and hope of the resurrection. The burial of the dead is a corporal work of mercy. It honors the children of God who are temples of the Holy Spirit. So you might be thinking, well, that's well and good and all, but what's the deal with taking their bones and their blood? After all, if we need to treat the bodies of the dead with respect, how do we justify chopping them up like that? Well, there are three biblical data points to know here. The first one is Acts chapter 5, verses 14 to 15, which says that more than ever, believers were added to the Lord, multitudes, both of men and women, so that they even carried out the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and pallets, that as Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on some of them. Okay, so this shows us that healing flows, as it were, from the body of Peter. The people are going to Peter, laying down in front of him and hoping that they'll be healed just by his shadow passing by. That's so important, because if you or I did that today with the Pope or some great saint, we can be assured that our Protestant brothers and sisters would decry it as superstitious. But Acts depicts it as what early Christian faithfulness looks like. Okay, the second data point to know is Acts chapter 19, verses 11 to 12. Which says that God did extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul, so that handkerchiefs or aprons were carried away from his body to the sick, and diseases left them, and the evil spirits came out of them. So that drives the point home even more directly. Things that have touched St. Paul, or getting even more remote than his shadow, are being brought to the sick. And St. Luke, who wrote Acts, is clear that this is how God did extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul. That is, God isn't threatened by his saints. God works through his saints and through the bodies of his saints. The final verse to know is from the Old Testament, 2 Kings chapter 13, verse 21, which describes how a man's body was thrown into the grave of Elisha. And it says, as soon as a man touched the bones of Elisha, he revived and stood on his feet. Well, there, we see very explicitly healing, not just through a saint, but through the bones of a saint. In this case, certainly, an Old Testament saint. Taken together, these three passages paint a clear picture. Why do we take the bones to as many churches and as many places as we can? Because we believe that God likes to work miracles through his saints, including those, like Elisha, who have already fallen asleep in death. And so we share in the same faith as the early Christians. Like, we put ourselves in places where we can encounter the shadow of Peter, or the handkerchiefs of Paul, or the bones of the saints.
If you want to learn more about this topic or others like it, visit our website at Catholic.com. Also, visit CatholicAnswersSpeakers.com to learn how you can bring me and other Catholic Answers speakers to your event. For Catholic Answers, I'm Joe Heschmeyer. Thanks for watching.